guys, it's Jochmeer, and today I'm going to show you the Red Portal lure guide that we've been using ever since we started the clan. There are other Red Portal lure guides mine, else I wouldn't have made them because I don't like to leak stuff. And I think those aren't as good as ours is, so I'm just going to show ours. This is the lure guide we still use. And what you usually have is a guy skilling at the bank that convinces them to telegrab, and a talker which them there and says they're doing a giveaway and stuff, and the guy knows that's a lure, but he doesn't know that that the guy telling him to telegrab is also in on it. I'm mainly going to discuss the part with telegrab because the other thing is quite, it's not as hard. You just tell someone when you're doing a giveaway, tell them to bank their stuff and come Falador, and come to the Gamers Grotto, and you get them here, and then you say like, okay, I'm getting items too, let me check the bank, and they then at the bank you get some Armadale chain skirts, and you show them like I'm dropping that too. And in the real lure, you are actually dropping just one Armadale plate skirt, which almost looks the same in name, so that they think there's an Armadale chain skirt on the ground to get it if they know the 10k trick, because you're not dropping like 500 million k.
And then the guy comes in, the guy that tells telegrab, and you and he starts telling like, alright, it's a lure, I saw this lure on YouTube, and you should telegrab to anti-lure it. That's exactly what's happening on the video now. And you take him to the white portal and you say like, alright, according to the video they're going to drop here, so you take him there. At this point I really thought he was anti-luring, but it turns out he wasn't. My video was full, my data, so I didn't fit all. Just a spoiler. You should it shows the main part that I wanted to show. I'll get in on the killing later. You take them all the way west and you drop a bit of GPs on this exact spot, just two spots north of the tree, because a guy saying doing the giveaway will drop them one north of the tree. They think it's safe to telegraph from there if they stand at the right spot, and actually they get pulled in. You don't say that on all the spots they get pulled in, you say that's the only spot that works. They drop there because it avoids anti-lures. That's what makes the west drop spot so good. The east drop spot is a bit worse, I think. Make sure they don't stand one west, because they can actually telegrab it without getting pulled in. But that never happens. And even if that happens, you can still do the east drop spot. You really have to practice it all a bit, but that's fine. The talker is just in the red portal right now, and he's waiting on the guy to get his gear. But you can also say like a stalker, as the guy going to do a giveaway, that you're going AFK for a second, and that they should get gear when he's back. So he just locks in on the middle of this, or just after, or anywhere around that. And he then proceeds with the giveaway. You've really got to get that trust. That is really something you've got to practice. The hardest part is to improvise. They always react different to the anti-lure thing. and you've always got to answer the questions, and sometimes you gotta improvise quite a bit. Alright, now at the bank you get your gear in your inventory, don't equip it yet. If you get obvious killer gear, then that's not the part. About the gear, you best get a Seer's Ring for the crit bonus. Some skill cape or obby cape. A bit of ganodermic, which isn't even really needed. Your polypore staff, or the armor battle staff, that's fine. Or and batwing or something. Your body, legs, helm, boots and gloves does not matter for the accuracy, so that doesn't really matter what you get. And you get water and blood runes and adrenaline pot, overload, and some port tents and rocktail soups. You don't really need that high tier food. And the overloads are very useful, but you can use like extreme magics or normal super magic potions. The adrenaline pot is really useful when killing. You hit them once, normal hit, and then you hit them with three abilities, drink an adrenaline pot and you can asphyxiate. Normally you just have 10 seconds stun. But if you asphyxiate before the 10 seconds, you have another 6 seconds that they are stunned and that they can't run. So you can kill them in time. As you can hear, as you can see, my memory was out. I didn't have any memory left and it stopped recording without me knowing. So I'm just showing another video now. We actually got a blue mask from that guy that I just convinced in the other video. And I'm showing a lure where we get a dual rare lure with the same lure, a Santa hat and a mask. And as you can see, I waited for the sign from my talker. And I ran in and through the north spot, I ran all the way west from a bit north. And I'm now standing here. Sometimes I stand one step further north until the coins are spawned, then I walk one south. You face south always. I don't know if it really helps, but it can never hurt to stand face south. You overload when the talker has dropped the stuff. And you pull up, you pray. And you just wait for the coins to appear and for him to telegraph, and you kill him. Now, as for the killing, you should see him getting killed soon. Okay, so now I'm killing him. I left clicked him. If you right click, you already select an ability and use it on him. It's harder because you can do three hits and one normal hit, and then the asphyxiate, because the normal hit isn't there at the start. So if you have to right click, adrenaline pot aren't as useful because you will need 4 abilities or you will just be at 49%, and you hit 3 normal abilities, then overload and asphyxiate, and you kill him. And then you make bank. I recommend trying bandos and stuff first till you're a bit better. Don't ever forget to select a spell as attacker. It happens a lot that you don't select a spell. You should always check when you're there, and best is to check several times. If anti-leader comes, you protect item and tank, or you run out, or you log out. Doesn't really matter, don't ever risk too much if you don't know what you're doing. You can bring Phoenix necklaces or arcane steam. And well, you just make bank. Just read the description for more tips that I can't think of right now. And good luck luring.